And I actually want to put a point slightly different to technology when we're talking about cloud. I think Sabnana touched about that, which is the sort of one thing we heard about the benefits which it can bring about. One of the core benefits of a shared usage of application or reusing an application to bring about, if we talk about, is rapid time to deploy. With probably in my mind, a huge benefit which can come as a result of that. What I'm getting at is that gCloud, the technology for that may be there, but we need to create a burning platform for it by sharing applications across states or across departments. That needs to become the real starting point for cloud to succeed. We don't want to probably do cloud for the sake of it. The real business benefit which we will get is reusing of an application which is created by allowing that service to be made available to millions others who are not able to get the benefit of that service today. So if you position it in that context, I think the benefit is immense. So the technology part of it is probably the much easier aspect. We spoke about the DLK and the I'd like to call it an experiment, having been one of the architects, the person who ran that entire experiment. What that proved, and I'll spend a couple of minutes on that, what that did was, these three services, which were running successfully in MP, and which had taken about 24 months to implement in MP, were replicated in JNK using the multi-tenanted application of MP in less than 45 days, with zero incremental cost, and one of the key benefits Ms. Padmanabhan mentioned. So the power of technology to be able to do that is immense. The giver and taker worked initially. Why it failed thereafter, and I'm using a very strong word having been involved with that, was the politics behind it. Somebody, at the sort of the political consensus required to work cross states could not sustain over a longer period of time. So, while sort of there was money made available by DIT to roll it out in a much faster way, while the technology was proven, while MP was willing to sort of provide the platform, that one bottleneck sort of didn't allow it to scale up, and millions of people in JNK not getting the benefit of something which was there. So I think somewhere we need to solve this collaboration problem, the taker problem, I call it. In my discussions around this pilot I've had with at least more than a dozen state governments, everybody is more than willing to give what they've done well, nobody is willing to take. The pride comes in between, how can I take from somebody else? I have done so much better, tell me, is there a state who's willing to take my application? I'm more than willing to give. This one issue we need to break, and sir, with your commitment, which we sort of heard you talk about this, and I think your persuasion which we've seen over the last many years, that's one thing. There's nothing wrong if I've done something well, somebody else has done something well. Maybe we can create a barter program versus a giver-taker program. I'll give you one, you take that, you give me one, I'll take that. So that stigma, again maybe I'm using a strong word, but that stigma of being a recipient, if that goes away, I'm sure sort of the technology will help us do it. But this mindset to break is absolutely crucial. The benefit at the application level, Singh spoke about the outcome orientation, are huge. By infrastructure sharing will save some cost. Good for a country like India, but I think over the last few years what I've seen is money is not been the problem, the outcome has been the problem. So outcome will come by application sharing in a real sense, by getting people to work together, barter, and put due emphasis on this aspect. I'm sure technology will not be a reason why we will fail on this, like the whole government. Sort of the slower adoption, although a lot has happened, is not because of any of the technology that we have. It is more towards the soft aspect of the monitoring around